Okay, now we will see the last topic in our second unit, that is programmability in Hive. How we will do programming concepts in Hive language. So you remember the previous topics that we saw about introduction of big data, 3 V's of big data, and Hadoop architecture, HDFS, that is Hadoop distributed file system, and MapReduce architecture. And in programmability, the PIC concept. And the last programmability concept is Hive that we will see now. So this is the logo of Hive. So what it is Hive? Hive na enna appadina? It is the open source data warehousing solution that is built on top of Hadoop. Data warehousing solution. Data warehouse pathi deal pandrathu dhaan vandu Hive appadina the concept. And it is open source. It resides on top of Hadoop. Hadoop or the architecture abstract la, Hadoop or the malaga in the Hive abdingra that is being residing. Main purpose of Hive is to summarize the big data and make scoring and analyzing easy. To make scoring and analyzing easy. And initially the Hive was developed by Facebook. Facebook only just developed the Hive initially. Later the Apache Software Foundation, they took that particular Hive and they developed it further as an open source under the name Apache Hive. So first one, the Facebook developed pannanada Apache software vaangi avanga adukku mele inga konja develop panni open source maati Apache Hive ngra name la they released. So it is mostly suited where the static data is analyzed. Fast response are not required and when the data is not changing rapidly. அதாவது இன்ஸ்டன்ட் ஃபீட்பேக் அந்த மாதிரி ரியல் டைம் சுச்சுவேஷனுக்கெல்லாம் இது வந்து எங்கெல்லாம் தேவையில்லையோ அங்கெல்லாம் உங்களுக்கு வந்து ஹை யூஸ் ஆகும். தட் இஸ் ஸ்டாட்டிக் டேட்டா தான் அனலைஸ் பண்ணுது. ரெஸ்பான்ஸ் டைம் எப்படி எப்போ கிடைச்சாலும் போதும், உடனடியாக டேட்டா நம்மளுக்கு தேவையில்லை, அதே மாதிரி டேட்டா ஃபாஸ்டாக சேஞ்ச் ஆகிறது இல்லை அப்படிங்கிற மாதிரி இருக்கக்கூடிய சுச்சுவேஷனில் இருக்கக்கூடிய டேட்டா வேர்ஹவுசிங் ப்ராப்ளம்ஸ்க்கு இந்த ஹை இஸ் அ குட் சொல்யூஷன். அண்ட் ஹடூப் ப்ரொவைட்ஸ் மேசிவ் ஸ்கேல் அவுட் அண்ட் ஃபால்ட் டாலரன்ஸ் கெப்பாபிலிட்டிஸ் ஃபார் டேட்டா ஸ்டோரேஜ் and processing on commodity hardware, and this Hive is designed to enable easy data summarization and have querying and analysis of large volumes of data. So query database data warehouse அப்படிங்கிறதுல query அப்படிங்கற இந்த purposeல தான் அந்த Hive வந்து உள்ள வருது. And at the same time it also the queries மட்டும் இல்லாம it is going to analyze large volumes of data. This is the basic introduction about Hive. So any features in Hive, any features you can pathinga na, it stores the schema in a database and process the data into HDFS. In both ways this particular Hive stores the schema in the database and the process the data into HDFS. Schema vayum seri process ana data vayum seri rendayume HDFS kulla store pandrathu one of the main feature of Hive. And it provides access to files stored in HDFS and query execution via MapReduce. MapReduce valiya query execution avandu nadathikkirukum and Hive concept edupu. And it is designed for OLAP, online analytical processing apringra and the processing ku dhaan vandu Hive is being designed. It is not designed for OLTP, that is online transactional processing, that is real time response. Nam inge paathomla response time vandu theevramba theve illa adhula dhaan vandu இந்த ஹை வந்து வர்க் ஆகும். அண்ட் ரியல் டைம் ஆன ப்ராசஸிங்க்கு இது வந்து தேவை கிடையாது. இட் ப்ரொவைட்ஸ் எஸ்கியூஎல் டைப் லாங்குவேஜ் ஃபார் கொரிங் கால்டு ஹை கியூஎல் ஆர் ஹெச்கியூஎல். ஹைவ் அப்படிங்கிற அந்த பர்டிகுலருக்குள்ள நம்ம எஸ்கியூஎல் அப்படிங்கிற இந்த லாங்குவேஜ் கொரி லாங்குவேஜை உள்ள நுழைக்கிறோம். அதனால இட் இஸ் கால்டு ஹை கியூஎல் ஆர் ஹெச்கியூஎல். ஹை வேல்யூஸ் ஆர் ஸ்கேலபிலிட்டி எக்ஸ்டென்சிபிலிட்டி ஃபால்ட் டாலரன்ஸ் லூப் கப்ளிங் வித் இட்ஸ் இன்புட் ஃபார்மெட். அந்த மாதிரியான இன்புட் ஃபார்மட்ல தான் வந்து ஹைவுக்கு நம்ம வேல்யூஸ் கொடுக்கும். ஹைவ் அலோஸ் எஸ்கியூஎல் டெவலப்பர் டு ரைட் ஹைவ் கொரி லாங்குவேஜ் அதான் ஹெச்கியூஎல் ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட் தட் ஆர் சிமிலர் டு ஸ்டாண்டர்ட் எஸ்கியூஎல் ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் கொரிங் டேட்டா ஸ்டோர்ட் இன் ஹடூப் கிளஸ்டர். நார்மல் எஸ்கியூஎல் ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட்ஸ்ல எப்படி நம்ம வந்து கொரி பண்ணுவோமோ அதே மாதிரியான ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட்ஸ்ல இங்க ஹெச்கியூஎல்னு சொல்றோம், ஹைவ் கொரி ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட்ஸ்னு சொல்றோம். They are broken down by the Hive service into MapReduce jobs and executed across the Hadoop cluster. Hive and HDFS. MapReduce and processing carry over. Hope you remember the MapReduce concept that we saw in the previous class. And Hive translates most queries to MapReduce jobs, thereby exploiting the scalability of Hadoop by presenting a similar SQL abstraction. நம்மளுக்கு வந்து எஸ்கியூஎல் மாதிரி தான் தெரியும் பட் உள்ள நடக்கக்கூடிய அந்த டிரான்ஸ்லேஷன் ப்ராசஸ் எல்லாமே வந்து ஹைவ் வந்து மேப் ரெடியூஸ் வழியா எக்ஸிக்யூட் பண்ணி ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் கால்ட் ஹைவ் ஆர்கிடெக்சர் திஸ் இஸ் ஹைவ் பார்ட் அண்ட் திஸ் இஸ் தி ஹடூப் பார்ட் மேப் ரெடியூஸ் கெட் இன்வால்வ் தீஸ் ஜாப் டிராக்கர் நேம் நோட் டேட்டா நோட் டாஸ்க் டிராக்கர் தீஸ் ஆர் ஜாப்ஸ் தட் ஆர் அவைலபிள் இன் மேப் ரெடியூஸ் ஸோ தீஸ் ஒர்க்ஸ் ஆர் பீங் கேரிட் அவுட் பை HDFS through MapReduce concept. And this is outline of Hive architecture, CLI, JDBC, ODBC, Thrift server, and compiler executor optimizer. So we will see in depth of this Hive architecture. What are the components that are available in Hive architecture? The first component, you call it as external interface. External interface is nothing but user interfaces like CLI, that is a character level interface and a graphical user level interface, component level interface, like this interface, communication valiya irukkuradha call it as interface. And at the same time, APIs, application programming interface like JDBC, ODBC, like this type of interface, you call it as the first component of architecture. And the second component is Thrift server. Thrift server is nothing but, it is a framework for cross-language services. Cross-language services, client server request carry over pandrathu the Thrift server odava. And third one is Metastore. Metastore is nothing but it stores the metadata and statistical database, tables and partitions. So the theviyana ella metadata vum idu vena store da store pannirukum. It is nothing but it is maybe called as a relational database or file system. And the metadata angada for file la store aayirukum. The last component of Hive, we call it is the driver, compiler, optimizer and executor. The first part and that is the driver. It manages the life cycle of Hive QL statement and it uses the session handle to keep track of a statement. And the second one, compiler, it translates the query statements into a plan. Query irukkiradhu or plan ka convert pandradha compiler oda vela. Query statements mean you may involve with DDL statement like metadata operations and load statement, HDFS operations, the last part of load pathole and the load statement and MapReduce, the direct acyclic graph notation type under DAG by using insert query. In the madriyana processing carry over pandrathu compiler ngradoda vela. Next is optimizer. It combines the multiple joins and it adds pre-partition operator. It minimizes data transfers and pruning. It user hinted optimization. In the process, the optimizer will carry over. They are executed engine, runs the DAG for MapReduce jobs and Hadoop and proper dependency order. Then, the executor will execute. So, these are the overall architecture of the Hive interface, Thrift server, Metastore, and this components driver, compiler, optimizer, and executor. So, next we'll see about the data types that is available in Hive or four types. Four types of data types are available. First one, column type. Second, literal. Third, null value. And fourth, complex type. So four types. The first one is column type. Column type may be of integral type or string type. Integral means, as you are already familiar with this keyword, int. When the data range exceeds the range of int, you have to use big int. And if the data range is smaller than the int, you have to use small int. If that particular is also range is also smaller, you can use tiny int because tiny int is smaller than the small int. And if you come to string type data types can be specified using single quotes or double quotes, and it contains two data types, varchar and character. And Hive follows the C type escape sequence characters. And the next column type is timestamp. Timestamp means you know that particular year, month, date, hour, minute, second format. And date means that is described in year, month, day format. This is the format that is available in date column type. So this is the first data type is column type of four, integral, string, timestamp and date. And the fifth column type is decimal. The decimal type in Hive is the same as big decimal format of Java. And next type is union. You know it is already, it is a collection of heterogeneous data types. Similar data types is called as a union type. Next comes the literal data type. Literal in the sense floating point and decimal type is two types. Floating point is nothing but numbers with decimal point. And generally this type of data is composed of double data type. And decimal type data is nothing but floating point value with higher range than the double data type. Here it's just numbers with a decimal point. Here you can say higher range. And the range of decimal type is approximately minus 10 to the power minus 308 to 10 to the power 308. This is the highest range of a decimal point that is available in high literature. And the fourth type is a complex type. There are three types: arrays, maps, and structs. Arrays is same way that you have seen in other programming languages, similarly like Java. This is the syntax of array data type. And maps, like Java maps, this is the syntax: map, primitive type, comma data type, and struct. It is similar to complex data. At the same time, we can also include comments here. So three complex types are available: arrays, maps, and structs. This is about data types, exclusively about data models, Hive data model. The data in Hive has been organized into mainly three types. One, you call it as table, next one partition, and third one bucket. So this is the table, this is the partition, and this is the bucket. So table means you call it as an overall database, and partition, you combine into HDFS, a single directory, subdirectory is called as a partition. And within the subdirectory, you will have a file that is called as a bucket. So first, table is somewhat similar to relational tables that you see in other languages, database languages. Each table has a corresponding directory in HDFS. The data is serialized and stored as files within the directory. Hive has default serialization built in, which supports compression and lazy deserialization. User can specify custom serialization, deserialization schemes. So it is nothing but that is a relational table that you see in like Oracle SQL, like that. And particular table will have a corresponding directory that will be enough serialized concept. Next is partition. Each table can be broken into partition. Partitions determine the distribution of data within subdirectories. Like what this diagram looks like, the partition determines the how the partition determines that how the data is stored, and each unique value of the partition key defines the partition of the table, and the partitions are named after date convenience. So partition is nothing but the table is been broken down into some parts. So this is what the example that you see in SQL. This is example create table. This is the table name. This is a column name. Sale ID is a column, amount is a column, and that particular sales table you are partitioning by the column country, year, and month. So after partitioning, this is the keyword to use to partition that particular sales table. So this partition is split out into different folders like sale, country, year, month. Sales table has been partitioned into country, into year, into month. See, this particular statement is this country, year, and month. The partition into, now we have different folders like country is US, year is equal to 2012, and month is equal to 12. Like this, this particular table has been partitioned into different folders. And then last model is bucket. Bucket is nothing but data that is in each partition is divided into buckets. இண்டிவிஜுவலாக இந்த பார்ட்டிஷன் இது வந்து ஒரு பார்ட்டிஷன் நீங்கள் சொல்கிறப்போ இந்த பார்ட்டிஷனுக்குள்ளே இருக்கக்கூடிய டேட்டாவை யூ கால் இட் அஸ் பக்கெட் ஸோ பேஸ்ட் ஆன் த ஹேஷ் ஃபங்க்ஷன் ஆஃப் த காலம் தட் இஸ் ஹேஷ் காலம் ஹேஷ் ஃபங்க்ஷன் அப்படின்னாவே யூ வில் டேக் மாடல் அஸ் ஆப்ரேட்டர் ஸோ ஹெச் ஆஃப் காலம் மாட் நம்பர் ஆஃப் பக்கெட் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு பக்கெட் நம்பர் ஸோ ஈச் பக்கெட் இஸ் ஸ்டோர்ட் அஸ் அ ஃபைல் இன் பார்ட்டிஷன் டைரக்டர் அந்த பக்கெட்ஸ்க்குள்ள இந்த டேட்டாவை எப்படி ஃபைண்ட் பண்ணுவோம்னா பை யூசிங் திஸ் ஹேஷ் ஃபங்க்ஷன் திஸ் ஹேஷ் hash function helps to find out that particular value of that bucket. So buckets cluster nu solrom the data va indha maradha nama pirichu vechirukom. So this is overall the hierarchy of the Hive data model. The hierarchy of the Hive partition, tables, partitions, buckets nu solrom. So table ngrappo overall you can call it as a student detail. As a partition na neenga pirikringa department wise, computer science department, commerce department, management department and pirikringa, that you call it as a partition. And the partition color, you have some data values that you call it as bucket. And the bucket over no color, you will have these individual files as the data. So this is what the Hive data model looks like for process of analyzing and querying this particular data. So three types of operations in Hive are available. First one, DDL. DDL is nothing but you know about data definition language. DML, data manipulation language, SQL, structured query language. So three types of operations you can execute in Hive. You can create a table, you can manipulate those table, and you can query those tables. So these are the DDL operations that occur in Hive. Create DOP and alter database, use database, create drop truncate table, alter table partition column, create drop alter view, create alter drop alter index, create drop function, create drop grant revoke roles and privileges, show, describe, export, import. So these are the types of DDL operations that can be executed in the Hive. Since Hive is somewhat similar to SQL language. So these are the operations example. As you already said, these are the create alter in the statement of undana examples now that has been given in this slide. Create table na Hive create table invites. This is the column name that has been partitioned by the string. This is similar to alter table, event spokes invites. These are altering and here you are dropping the table. Next is DML operation. That particular files will be loaded into tables, writing data into file system from queries, inserting data into Hive tables from queries, and updating value, inserting value, deleting value. So these are the operations that is being carried out in DML. So this is the syntax of DML. Load data into the table. Load data, local, and path. Write data. This is the particular syntax of overriding the table and write partition. This is the syntax for writing the data into files. Next is the DDL operation that is being carried out with SQL is selection, filter, group by, insert, overwrite, and insert into, join, multi-table insert, pluggable, map-reduced, script using transform, we call it as extensibility. These are the operations that has been carried out in Hive for SQL operations. This is select, insert, from group by clause, since group by, select and filters, insert, override, join. These SQL operations are being carried out in Hive. Group by means you know you're going to sort in particular order. It may be a ascending order or it may be a descending order. And this is for example for join and this is example for multi-table insert. So as with any database management system, user can run Hive queries in many ways. A command line interface that you call it as Hive shell, and a Java database connectivity that you may call as JDBC, open database connectivity called as ODBC, and a Hive Thrift client. As we already saw in the previous architecture, Thrift is nothing but cross language platform ka support aagaradha Thrift in sonna. So anga server sonna inga vandu client. So it is like any database file that gets installed on user's client machine. So overall, you need a Hive query insert execute pannanumna, you need a Hive shell, you need a application interfaces like JDBC or ODBC and a Hive Thrift client. So overall, Hive Hubbing repo, it is an open source data warehousing solution for the purpose of querying and analyzing data. So adukku use pandrathu vandu OLAP abingra language கான்செப்ட யூஸ் பண்ணுறோம். ஓலாப் அப்படிங்கிறப்ப உங்களுக்கு உடனடியான இமீடியட் ரெஸ்பான்சஸ் தேவையில்லை, மெதுவான ப்ராசஸிங்கில் இருக்கக்கூடிய டேட்டா தான் ஓலாப்னு சொல்லுவோம். ஸோ அங்கே தான் இங்கே யூஸ் பண்ணுறோம் இந்த ஹைவை. எஸ்கியூஎல் கூட இன்டர்பிரட் ஆனதுனால யூ கேன் கால் அஸ் ஹைஎஸ்கியூஎல் ஆர் எச்கியூஎல். ஸோ ஓவரால் அதோட ஆர்கிடெக்சர் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா இப்படி தான் இருக்கும். இன்டர்ஃபேஸ், அந்த இன்டர்ஃபேஸ் வந்து யூசர் இன்டர்ஃபேஸாக இருக்கலாம், இல்லை அப்ளிகேஷன் ப்ரோக்ராமிங் இன்டர்ஃபேஸாகவும் இருக்கலாம், அண்ட் ஒரு ஸ்கிரிப்ட் சர்வர் கிராஸ் கம்யூனிகேஷனுக்கு, ஸ்டோரேஜுக்கு மெட்டா சர்வர், and the component driver, compiler, optimizer, executor. It is overall a developer architecture. And next comes the data types. Four types are there. Column, literal, null value, complex. Column types la pathinga appadina you have integral, string, timestamp, date, decimal, and union type. So six types column types la irukku. And the next one is literals are two types, floating point and decimal point. And complex la arrays, maps and struct. These are data types, but then high level data type. And next is the data model. Na, three types in solra. Tables, partition, bucket, table, overall table. Other individual and group panona comes the partition. And the group and individual individual data, I call it as files. So overall example, every diagram in the diagram. This is the table, this is the partition, and this is the bucket. This is the values in the hierarchy. And so three operations na DDL, DML, and SQL. So DDL create alter concept. That is the examples. That is DML na inserting, updating, deleting. That is the examples. And SQL operation repos, group filter, select a group by, insert, join. That is the examples. So overall, in the execute panderko, you need a command line interface that I call it as Hive Shell, and JDBC and ODB is the connectivity. Hope you understand about what is Hive.